The topic tonight is the hippies, an understanding of whom we must, I guess, acquire or die painfully.
Die painfully.
Now it's jazz, the place is roaring, all beautiful girls in there, one mad brunette at the bar, drunk with her boys. One strange chick I remember from somewhere, wearing a simple skirt with pockets, her hands in there. Short haircut, slouched, talking to everybody. Up and down the stairs they come, the bartenders and the regular band of Jack and the heavenly drummer who looks up in the sky with blue eyes, with a beard. He's wailing beer caps of bottles and jamming at the cash register and everything is going to the beat. It's the beat generation, it's Bayat. It's the beat to keep, it's the beat of the heart. It's being beat and down in the world and like old time lowdown. And like in ancient civilizations, the slave boatmen rowing galleys to a beat. And servants spinning pottery to a beat. The faces. There's no face to compare with Jack Mingers, who's up on the bandstand now with a colored trumpeter who outblows him wild and dizzy, but Jack's face overlooking all the heads and smoke. He has a face that looks like everybody you've ever known and seen on the street in your time. Sweet face, hard to describe. Sad eyes, cruel lips, expectant gleam, swaying to the beat, tall, majestical. Waiting in front of the drugstore. A face like Hunky's in New York. Hunky, whom you'll see on Times Square, somnolent and alert. Sad, sweet, dark, holy. Just out of jail. Martyred. Tortured by sidewalks. Starved for sex and companionship. Open to anything. Ready to introduce a new world. Shrug. Colored big tenor with the big tone is blowing sunny stits clear out of Kansas City roadhouses. Clear, heavy, somewhat dull and unmusical ideas which nevertheless never leave the music. Always there, always far out. The harmony too complicated for the motley bums of music understanding in there. But the musicians here. The drummer is a sensational 12-year-old Negro boy who's not allowed to drink, but can play. Tremendous, a little lithe, childlike Miles Davis kid. Like early Fats Navarro fans you used to see in S-Bahn Harlem, hep, small. He thunders at the drums with a beat which is described to me by a near-standing connoisseur with beret as a fabulous beat. On piano is Blondie Bill, good enough to drive any group. Now Jack Ringer blows out and over his head with these angels from Fillmore. I dig him, now he's terrific. I just stand in the outside hall against the wall, no beer necessary, with collections of in-and-out listeners with Bernie, and now here returns Bob Berman. Who was a kid from West Indies who barged into my party 6 months earlier with Dean in the gang, and I had a Chet Baker record on and we hoofed it at each other in the room. Tremendous. The perfect grace of his dancing, casual, like Joe Louis, casually hoofing. He comes now in dancing like that, glad. Everybody looks everywhere, it's a jazz joint and beat generation mad trick. You see someone, hi! Then you look away elsewhere for something, someone else, it's all insane. Then you look back, you look away, around, everything is coming in from everywhere in the sound of the jazz. Hi! Hey! Bang! The little drummer takes a solo, reaching his young hands all over traps and kettles and cymbals and foot pedal boom in a fantastic crash of sound. 12 years old, what will happen?
A dull or dangerous thing. To do a dull thing with style is preferable to doing a dangerous thing without it. To do a dangerous thing with style is what I call art.
Die painfully.
Came in here yesterday and jumping the jittery around, and I sort of looked like I was high, so I just let people think I was high.
Cosmic consciousness before. There is an experience one seems to get under LSD that a lot of people talk about as putting them in touch with all things, with all people. And there's an effort, kind of an extremist effort at love.